classical extensive and scattered, screening the screen for a wide range of illness. There are multiple treatment options, but still it is confusing. There are lots of treatment options are there, particularly. But even for the skin disorders, when they are going to the Western dermatologist, they are just changing the products. They are prescribing various drugs like antihistamine or antibiotics or antifungal or sometimes chemotherapeutic agent, sometimes immunosuppressant medicine. But they are just changing the product. But otherwise, the protocol remains the same. So this is the main thing. When they are coming to us, we need to take all the care of all this financial conditions, physical condition, emotional condition of the patient, and then our role can start. So skin disease in Ayurveda like Kushta, Sitta Pitta, Visarpa, Udarda, Kotha, Uttar Kotha, Visarpa, Mansurika, Romantika. So all these kind of skin disorders has been described in Ayurvedic text. Now let us know, as I am a physician, I am practicing in dermatology, and particularly when you are practicing in any field of Ayurveda, I am always request or I am suggesting all the Ayurvedic physicians to have a knowledge of Western science also. Because maximum fraternity, as they are practicing skin or in cancer, patient will come to you after the failure of this Western medicine. But you must have some knowledge of some Western medicine, some drugs, the side effects of the drug, and everything. Otherwise, though we are the master of this Ayurvedic science, but sometimes we cannot get that much success what we, the patient is expecting and the, what we want to give them. So that is why we need to have a knowledge of Western dermatology or Western oncology or whatever the field we are practicing. So skin immune system also we need to know. The skin has an important role in the host defense, right? When skin exposed to a new antigen, this activated antigen expressing Langerhans cells migrate from the skin to lymph nodes. And this activation of Navy T cells, and these T cells become memory T cells and then accumulation in response to cutaneous injury. So when skin disease has been taking place in the body, there is some reason here they are taking this as a cutaneous injury. So this is a basic skin immune system that we must know. Now today what we are going to discuss, we will going to discuss about epidemiology and pathophysiology. We are going to discuss about some clinical presentation, diagnosing psoriasis, managing psoriasis, some case studies that is very important, because if we have some success story, we have some data of the patient. Right now all everywhere people are asking for Ayurveda, evidence-based Ayurveda right now. The thing is going on about the COVID, what our Prime Minister has said, just generate the evidence, right? So everywhere, when I'm going to USA or everywhere, they are asking, show your data, how many patients you are working and how much the result, and what is the line of treatment, and how, what is the efficacy of your treatment. So we need to have good case studies when we are practicing. That is very important, you know, for the newcomer, those who are junior. Because lots of the time when I'm visiting various countries or when I'm posting on Facebook about this before and after treatment photographs, lots of doctors, including seniors, they are all the time asking me to share your line of treatment. I'm not doing nothing new herbs, because we know we are working in a framework. We have lots of herbs, but there are some herbs that they are very common and we are using it. But the thing is, our approach, that is very important. How to treat the patient, which herb is using, that is not important. But your approach to the patient, your attitude with the patient, that is very important. And that's why I'm not saying the line of treatment, because I'm not doing something different in the herbs. I'm doing the difference with my approach. And that is the key of my success. So let us now move to the word psoriasis. So psoriasis is the word derived from the Greek word psora and isis. Psora means itch or scale, and isis means condition. So psoriasis is an inflammatory disorder that affects the skin and nails. It is marked by the patches of thick red skin covered with silvery scales that occur primarily on the elbows, knees, lower back, skull. Although it's not life-threatening, but I observed toxic and very chronic psoriatic patient. I have reported few patients, they try to attempt for the suicide. So it can be painful and cause psychological and emotional distress. And why I am focusing maximum right now when I am conducting CME, people want to learn about all the skin disorders. But psoriasis is the only skin disease that manifests all the signs and symptoms of other skin disorders also. That's why I am focusing maximum on psoriasis. If you treat or if you manage the psoriasis, if you learn something about the psoriasis, then other skin disorders may be easy to treat for you. That's why most of the time I am focusing on psoriasis. So what is psoriasis? So I told you about this. It's an inflammatory and hyperplastic disease of the skin, characterized by the erythema and elevated scaly plaques, chronic relapsing condition. Now here our immune system mistake the skin cells as pathogen and sends the faulty signals, and that multiply the growth of the skin cells. So this is the basic pathophysiology of the psoriasis. So it's an autoimmune disorder described in Western dermatology. Now here we can correlate it with our Ayurvedic Acharya Charak and describe this as a ekakushta. Now this disease has been considered to be a multifactorial origin. A genetic influence is also in the position of psoriasis. It is now fairly well established. I will tell you and I will correlate with how these genetic factors also affect in Ayurvedic terminology also. So a sharp, definable border, a bright red color and silvery white scale demarcates lesions of psoriasis. Now, the main thing is that there occur an accelerated proliferation of keratinocytes as well as distributed cell maturation. This epithelial cell proliferation is increased, resulting a 12-fold shortening of the cell cycles. What happened? The turnover rates of normal epidermis is about 57 hours, 57, almost 21 days. Here it is shortened by 37.5, which means almost about 1.5 days. So how fast skin cell multiplication is taking place? So normally 457 hours is the epidermic life. So here the epidermis turnover is just 37.5 hours. That's why we are having a scaling all the time, scaling all the time. So this is the typical sign and symptoms of psoriasis. Now we need to correlate how ekakushta and psoriasis. Symptomatically, Acharya Charak has mentioned that Mahamasya Sakalopam, like scales of fish, it is described in Charak Chikisastan. Now in psoriasis, we just compare it. Well-defined raised macules, papules and plaques of erythema covered with silvery scales. So this is the similarity. So that's showing that there is a microphone. Hello. Yes. Second, Mahavastum. Lesions are many a time all over the body. The uninvolved skin is also abnormal. So this is a typical comparison of both of the things. Now, Asvedana, that is also one of the signs and symptoms mentioned in Charak Samhita. Here, lesions are dry and rough. Second, Krishna Varna, blackish red in color. So here also you can say raised erythematous, non-indurated, thick lesions become black in color, and that is called a rhomboid sign. So this is a comparison between ekakushta and a psoriasis. Now signs and symptoms, itchy, I already described itchy, dry and covered with silvery, blacky cells, skins, pink in color, red and thin, and most of the time you will find all over the body. starting maximum time I observed starting from the skull. Most of the time patients avoiding dandruff. They are not taking treatment for the dandruff, and that dandruff gradually converted into the psoriasis that I clinically observed. Now we need to know something about Western dermatological terminology. The diagnostic tool, that is when a psoriatic laser is scratched with a pin point of a dissecting forceps, a candle grease like scale can be repeatedly produced even from the non-scaling lasers, and this is called candle grease sign. This is one of the diagnostic tool we can use, that is called candle grease sign. Second is Ohrspeed sign. Complete removal of a scale, when you find there is a scale, if you remove it, the scale produces pinpoint bleeding, that is called Ohrspeed sign. This is very common. I just posted a few months back one of the picture of the psoriasis patient before treatment. One dermatologist came to my page and asked me, have you find any Ohrspeed sign? Then I told, yes, I find no Ohrspeed sign. That is the confirmatory test. So these lesions are slightly raised above the surface of the skin, but there is no indurations. Now this is Koebler phenomenon. That is also one of the important tools we need to know. That skin, knees, garden scrapes and bug bites of summer are annoying to everyone. But in people with psoriasis, these minor skin traumas can also trigger what's called the Koebler phenomenon. Psoriasis plaques that form at the site of a skin injury. So this is a very typical sign, and it is observed by or invented by the German dermatologist, Dr. Henrik Koebler, a German dermatologist who noticed this phenomenon in 19th century. So Koeblerization, that is very common. A cut or a bite that damage the dermis, a layer of the skin below the surface, may already begin to show the lesions. Almost 50% of the psoriasis patients, they are experiencing this Koebler phenomenon. So we must have these three main diagnostic tool according to the Western dermatology. Most of the time patients are coming with confirmed diagnosis, but right now the awareness regarding Ayurveda is increasing. So maximum time patients are coming in a very early stage of the psoriasis too, because they know the side effects of the Western medicine. So they also know that there is no management of skin disorders in the Western dermatology. So most of the time patients are coming in a very early stage of the psoriasis. So that is why we need to know the diagnostic tool according to the Western dermatology. Now the disease severity, that is also we need to know. Mild psoriasis affects less than 3% of the body surface. Most cases of psoriasis are limited to less than 2% of the skin. Moderate psoriasis covers 3 to 10% of the skin. If more than 10% of the body is affected, the disease is considered severe. Now, how we can judge this? The palm of the hand equals to 1% of the body. This palm of our hand is equal to 1%. So, according to that, we need to find out the severity of the psoriasis patient. Now, some social impact of psoriasis. When the patient is coming, he or she is having some social impact. Like, first, they don't know about the fact file of psoriasis. Most of the psoriasis patient mistaken it as contagious. Almost, you notice 57% of the psoriasis patient, that is according to the National Psoriasis Foundation journal. Psoriasis mistaken for other diseases and trouble receiving in equal treatment in service like pools or saloon or spa like this thing. So these are the social impact of psoriasis. So we also need to know about this thing, because when the patient is coming to us, they have lots of questions, and we need to know, and accordingly we need to solve the queries what the patient is having. And the thing is that why we need to know about this thing, or why we need to normally I am practicing quite differently than other practitioners. I am spending maximum time in the clinic with the patient. Particularly for any problem, skin to cancer, we are providing minimum 1 to 1.5 to 2 hours consultation to the patient. That is our style. Most of the students or engineer or doctors are asking us how many patients you are taking in a day. So we are taking only 3 to 4 patients in a day, and other things we are doing online consultations also. But the thing is that why we are taking only few patients in a day? Because we are spending maximum time with the patient. Particularly for the skin disease patient, we need to have patience and we need to become a good listener. Why? Because psoriasis patient or chronic skin disorder patients, they are always avoiding at their home by the Western dermatologists or other doctors, because it's a common thing, the complaints are all the time they are having. So the family members also avoiding, they also don't want to listen to the complaints. When they go to the Western dermatologist, they are just interested to prescribe the medicine, nothing, and they want to collect the fees. So now it's our duty, being a Vaidya, we need to know, we need to at least get in touch with the patient emotionally. Once the patient attached with us emotionally, then our role become very easy. Then patient will follow all the things very easily, right? So it's our duty to spend maximum time with the patient. We need to listen, we need to have all the files, we know all the things is confirmed. Still, just for the patient satisfaction, we need to watch, we need to read all the things in the file, then we need to discuss all the things as darshan or prasan or prasthay. We need to ask the questions, and we also need to listen. Though frequently, sometimes they are repeatedly complaining, but we need to have patience, silently we need to listen. Then if patient convinced, then it will be easy for us to start the treatment and to convince them to follow the diet and lifestyle medications. Because it's not easy that by just giving the medicine or by starting the treatment, we can cure all the diseases. As you all are the doctors of Ayurveda. So our role is having a combination of lifestyle, diet, stress management, and last treatment. So now, some common trigger factors for psoriasis. First is infection, like streptococcal viral infection. If you notice, particularly right now, this COVID is going on, and this mutations has been changed, and this latest mutations, it is affecting on the skin also. I think there is a picture is also moving in the social media. So this is kind of viral infection also can trigger the psoriasis. Some skin trauma, that is vulnerable phenomenon. Psychological stress, that is very important. So we need to focus on the stress management, particularly when we are dealing with the psoriasis patient. Sunburn, metabolic factors like calcium deficiency, hormonal factors, sometimes pregnancy or sometimes what I can say, menopause period of the female. So we also need all this, need to know about these triggering factors. Some provocation factor, first is emotional stress. The disease itself could produce a reactive depression, which could further exacerbate the disease. Some infection like streptococcal UTI has been shown to exacerbate psoriasis. Other infective foci from sinus, tonsil, gallbladder, and oral cavity may be the cause of exacerbation. Some drugs like some beta blocker, antihypertensive, NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, some antidepressant, some corticosteroid therapy withdrawal, alcohol, beverages, these are the provocation factor. So when, that's why we need to spend maximum time, we need to take proper history of the patient, we need to target the causative factors. Definitely, if we spend maximum time with the patient, we definitely at least identify what are the causative factors or aggravating factors for the psoriasis. Then we just focus on that factor and that make our treatment very easy. Other provocation factors, drugs that trigger the disease, worsen the symptoms, like angiotensin converting enzyme, that is ACE inhibitors, particularly this is antihypertensive drug that's used to treat high blood pressure and heart problems, beta blockers, chloroquine, a medicine used to treat malaria. Right now, hydroxychloroquine is going to be used for this COVID problem. Lithium for bipolar disorders, indomethacin, that is NSAID. So this kind of products the patient is taking, we also need to take the proper history. Some risk factor, family history. Perhaps the most significant risk factor for psoriasis is having a family history of the disease. About 40% of the people with psoriasis have a family member with the disease, although this may be underestimated. Some viral and bacterial infection like HIV or some viral infection likely to develop psoriasis than people with healthy immune system. Children and young adults with recurring infection, particularly strep throat, also may be at the increased risk. Hello? Kindly mute your microphone, please. Other risk factors like stress, because of stress, can impact the immune system. High stress level may increase the risk of psoriasis. Obesity, excess weight increase the risk of inverse psoriasis. In addition, plaque associated with all types of psoriasis, other develop in skin crease and folds. Smoking tobacco not only increase the risk of psoriasis but also may increase the severity of the disease. So smoking may also play a role in the initial development of the disease. So these are the risk factors. We need to know everything. We need to know complication of psoriasis. Like depending on the type of the location of the psoriasis, there are lots of complications may take place. Like fluid and electrolyte imbalance in the case of severe pustular psoriasis, and sometimes because of the scaling, you can see the vitamins and calcium deficiency. Low self-esteem. All the time, if the patient is chronic, definitely have low self-esteem, depression, stress, anxiety. These are the common things. We need to know complications and some social isolation. Patient is also having a social stigma because of the disease condition. So these are the complications. Now, causes of the psoriasis, right? The psoriasis was previously thought to be a disorder of primary of skin cell, keratinocytes, but is now recognized to be mediated by the immune system. So it is particularly, according to Western dermatology, this is autoimmune disorder. Changes in skin cells, differentiation and proliferation are the probably initiated and perpetrated by the T lymphocyte cells, and their sign signals to many other components of the immune system. So, main causative factor according to this, it is autoimmune disorder according to the Western dermatology. Now, the Ayurveda. According to the Ayurveda, we need to know the causative factors. According to the Ayurvedic classic, we are using the word Nidan. It carries two meanings, causative factors and diagnosis. It is very important to know the causes of a disease, because if any disease where the causes is known, treatment becomes very easy. So it is in this light that Chikitsa has been defined as Nidana Parivarjana. So we know the causative factors. What is our line of treatment first should be? That is Nidana Parivarjana. Avoid causative factors. So the causative factors are classified in the two groups, namely Bahya, external, and Abhyantar, that is internal. So Bahya Karanas are exogenous and Abhyantara are endogenous. So there are mainly two types of utilization of Nidana. First is a Roga product for the diagnosing purpose, and second is for the Roga Chikitsa, for the disease management. So all the Nidana working in three ways. We know that those Dushya Kara, initiated with doshas and dhatus, then dhatus Shaithilya Kara, sluggish the dhatu, Pavya Gunaya Kara, space for accumulation of initiated dosha, and they are producing the disorders. So here there are lots of internal factors like seven causative factors like three dosas and seven dhatus. Particularly in psoriasis, the main dosa involvement is vata and kapha. Bahya causative factor, that is dietary. I will told you about what are the diet inappropriate food combination. I will later on discuss all these things. the lifetime suppression of natural algae's uneven lifestyle, sudden switching over from upper tarpon to sun tarpon, or vice versa, misconduct. This is a very common iodine positive factor which is killing the virtuous persons, physical exercise, access to sexual indulgence. So these are considered as a lifetime. Papa karma is also particularly focusing on influence of action done in the past, present birth is also seen to be a positive factor of Kushta Roga. So these are the diet, lifestyle, papa karma. These are the sankraman is not a causative factor for the particular for thoracic because it is not contagious. But we can consider for other skin disorders, maybe lots of skin disorders, other like atopic dermatitis or eczema, they may be sankraman contact. Heredity, prakriti dosa, Kusht may be produced in the children by the vitiated humors of the patient Shukra and Sonika. So now some positive factors for skin disorders. According to the Ayurveda, skin disease may manifest when a person indulges in one or more of the below listed reasons like intake of incompatible food combinations such as meat, milk with fish, consumption of excessive amount of drink which are unattractive and heavy to digest, suppression of the urge to vomit or other natural urges, physical exercise or wandering in excessive heat after eating a heavy meal, haphazard intake of foods with hot and cold properties, use of cold water immediately after the exposure of scorching sun heat, exertion or exposure to the threatening situation, intake of excess food, uncooked food, eating before the complete digestion of the previous meal, that is Ama theory we can apply here, improper administration of ayurvedic detox therapy, excessive intake of food made by freshly harvested grain, curd, fish, salt and sour substances, excessive intake of black gram, reddish pastry, sesame seeds and jaggery, performance of sexual act while suffering with indigestion, sleeping during the daytime, that is what we can say divaswap, insulting people and engaging in sinful acts, and above all the main triggering factor, main causative factor of all skin diseases, stress. We need to focus more on stress. Most of the skin diseases are psychosomatic and stress is the most triggering factor to aggravate the skin disorders. So friends, when we are treating or dealing with the skin disorders, we need to focus on the stress management. Because maximum I have noticed during my all this clinical practice that patient is involved in one or more types of stress, and we need to find out which is the cause of the stress. First we need to find out the stress, then it will be easy to solve all the problems. So there are three types of stress and all three impacts the skin in different ways. First is mental stress, starts a chain reaction that ends in the drying out of Shlesha Kapha, the sub-dosha of Kapha that governs moisture balance in the skin. The drying of Shlesha Kapha causes skin to become thin and age earlier if the stress is not brought to the balance. So the srotas, micro channels that carry nutritive fluids to the skin also start to shrink, resulting to wrinkles and stress, illness, emotional stress also affects. So that is why we need to focus maximum on the stress management. Now the main four factors what we have noticed during our clinical practice, that is viruddha ahar, first is opposite diet. Mithya ahar means improper diet, mithya vihar means improper lifestyle, and sometimes some unknown causes. These are the main four primary causative factors we have identified, not only for psoriasis but maximum skin disorder including vitiligo too. Now we need to know what is contradictory to viruddha ahar. Now that is the very clear specifications definition of viruddha ahar mentioned in Ayurvedic text, that any diet which aggravates the doshas but does not eliminate them from the body is called as contradictory food. If the contradictory food is consumed repeatedly, it puts lower on the digestive fire, producing ama. And this is naturally can lead to any disease in the body. So here, this is very clear-cut definition of viruddha. Contradictory food, viruddhar, or we can say incompatible diet, which is harmful for health. The food which wrong in combination, which disturbs the balance among the body elements. Viruddhar is one of the unique concept in Ayurveda. Only Ayurveda is advocating about viruddhar. Otherwise, if they go to the dermatologist, they will not say anything about diet. Just they are prescribing the medicine, just take it. There is nothing, there is no diet plan, diet restriction or diet plan they are giving. So Ayurveda is the vast and ancient medical science, unlike other medical science. Ayurveda focuses more on healthy living. For healthy living, Ayurveda focus on consuming the right kind of diet. So today we'll discuss this sort of food which are having opposite effects on the when used to same time and may create toxins in the body. So contradictory food, viruddhar, in the modern technology and biochemistry aspect, we can easily elaborate the effects of viruddhar. Viruddhar have the opposite properties, opposite activities on the tissues, can create undesirable effects when combined if consumed wrong time. So Ayurveda literature has described various types of viruddhar. First is desha viruddha, the place viruddha, to have a dry and sharp substances in dry region, anakta substance in marshy land. This is first desha viruddha. Second is kala viruddha, time, intake of cold and dry substances in winter, pungent and hot substances in summer. So this is a kala viruddha. Agni, digestive fire viruddha, intake of heavy food when the power of digestion is low, intake of light food when the power of digestion is sharp, and intake of food at variance with irregular and normal power of digestion. So this is agni viruddha. Now matra, quality, quantity viruddha, intake of honey and ghee in equal quantity, that is a matra viruddha. Satmya, wholesome viruddha, intake of sweet and cold substances by person, accustomed to pungent and hot substances, that is called satmya viruddha. Dosha viruddha, utilization of drugs, diets and regimen having similar qualities with the dosas but at variance with the habit of individual. Samskar, mode of preparation, samskar viruddha, drugs and diet which when prepared in a particular produce the poisonous effects, like meat of peacock roasted on a kettle. So this is samskar viruddha. Dhirya viruddha, substances having cold potency in combination with those of hot potency. This is called dhirya viruddha. Kosta viruddha, to give less quantity with less potency and less tooth forming food to a person of costly bowel. Administration of more quantity, heavy and more stool forming food to a person having lax bowel. So that is called kosta viruddha. Avastha, state of the health viruddha, intake of vata aggravating food by a person after exertion, sexual act, physical exertion, or intake of kapha aggravating food by a person after sleep or drowsiness. So this is called avastha viruddha. Krama viruddha, sequence viruddha, the person takes food before his bowel and urination or when he doesn't have appetite or after his hunger have been aggravating. So this is called krama viruddha, sequence viruddha. Parihar viruddha, intake of hot things after taking pox. Upchar viruddha, treatment viruddha, cold things after taking ghee. Pek, cooking viruddha, preparation of food with bad or rotten fuel and under the cooking, overcooking or burning during the process of preparation. So this is pak viruddha, cooking viruddha. Samayoga, combination viruddha, intake of sour substances with meat. Hriday viruddha, intake of unpleasant food. Sampad, richness of quality viruddha, intake of substance that are not matured or over matured or putrefied. Vidhi, rules of eating group, taking meals in public place. So these are contradictory food. Now, little bit about incompatible food combination, that is also very important. You need to know about this thing. Like this, milk is incompatible with banana, fish, meat, curd and sour foods. Starches are incompatible with eggs, milk, banana and dates. Nightshades like potato, tomato, eggplants are incompatible with yogurt, milk, melons and cucumber. Yogurt is incompatible with sour fruits, hot drinks, fish, meat, mangoes and cheese. Lemon is incompatible with yogurt, milk, cucumber and tomatoes. So right now, most of the people, they don't know about what is the incompatible food, what is the correct food, what is the correct combination of the food. That's why people are consuming all these kinds of incompatible food, and that are the main positive factors. Because of these kind of positive factors, all three doshas simultaneously come up and induce defect the four body elements like vaka, rakta, mouse and lasika, and these four dushyas become morbid and lose their character. This provoke dosa settling themselves in the vitiated body elements and getting localized there, then vitiate them further and produce the kushta. Right? So this is a common pathogenesis of all the kushta and even we can say for the psoriasis. So aharaj, viharaj, nidana, sevan. Right? That prakopa, vata, pitta, kapha, here vata and kapha, they are the major, but later on it is also getting involved and it becomes chronic. Causes shithilta in four dhatus. These three doshas simultaneously causes shithilta in four dhatus. Saptadravya of this pushta reach to the shithil dhatus, tvak, get shifted there, causes dushti of tvakta and produce the pushta. Here we can say psoriasis. Some genetic factor now, according to Ayurveda, how the genetic factor is playing a role. So the chances of developing psoriasis increase when an individual with defective genes is exposed to the factor that disturb the vana, vata. Here, neuroendocrine system, we can say vata as neuroendocrine system and kapha as a immune system. Now, this result in deterioration and deficiency of the oja, that is immune system, disturb the metabolism and result in the production of amavisa, that is autoantibodies, that disturb the rasa dhatu and obstruct the rasa vahasrotasa, makes the skin cells vulnerable. Right? So this is a genetic factor. Now saprapti, all that is followed by the following events: abnormal vata and kapha, the amavisha, that is auto antibodies, while circulating across the body, affect already debilitated vahirtvakta. Vahirtvakta means epidermis, by the causative factors, disturb the sthanik oja, that is local defense, and vata dosha, that is local nervous control, bring about unprecedented faster koshanu utpatti, means cell division. Here cell division is very important. The whole process of cell division is so fast that normal cell multiplication taking place 1 month takes place here in 4 to 5 days. Consequently, huge piles of non-keratinized cells build up in the epidermis. Among with these, hyperactivity of the local pitta enzymes, see, later on pit also getting involved, result in the production of the inflammatory substances that result in local inflammation. These red patches and scales that itch severely. So usually heat and scratching aggravates the problem. So this is samprapti. Now the pathogenesis. Here dosha is kapha dushti with increased guru, sthira and mruduguna. Vata dushti with increased chala, ruksha and kharaguna. Agni is manda and visham with the production of amavisha. Srota, primarily rasava srota dushti take place followed by the involvement of other srota, srota mashi. Dushya, primarily rasa dhatu, pacha are involved followed by the involvement of other dhatus and tuku dhatus. And OJA, it is the root cause of all abnormalities. So this is a pathogenesis of psoriasis. So there are lots of terminology used in Ayurvedic text. Some are calling it Mandala Kushta. Some text says it is Eka Kushta or Kiti. Vata Pitta is more effective, but Vata prominently, Rajapit is always involved in psoriasis. So symptoms of psoriasis: scaling, itching, skin redness, tightness of the skin, bleeding, burning sensation, fatigue, and some other depression, some other factors, they are also playing role. So there are multiple other symptoms. May if it becomes chronic, then may manifest. So these are the pictures of psoriasis I would like to share with you, and symptoms of psoriasis. This is psoriasis pictures I would like to share with you. So already I told you about the signs and symptoms. So now this is very clear, very defined and sharply demarcated. This is the clinical symptoms of psoriasis: round and oval shaped lesions, usually symmetrical, erythematous, raised plaques covered by white silvery scales. These are the main clinical symptoms. Now, common site affected by psoriasis can affect any part of the body, typically scalp, elbow, knees, and sacrum. And extent of disease depends, varies, it depends. The types of psoriasis is very important. We need to know the types of psoriasis that I will tell you, like chronic plaque psoriasis, gutted psoriasis, flexural psoriasis, erythrodermic psoriasis, pustular psoriasis, localized, generalized, some local forms like palmoplantar, scalp, nail. These are the types of psoriasis. I will show you all the pictures. This is a chronic plaque psoriasis, most common type. Almost approximately 85% of the psoriasis patients are coming with the chronic plaque psoriasis, featured with the pink, very defined plaque with silvery scales. Lesions may be single or numerous. Plaques may involve large areas of the skin. So this is a chronic plaque psoriasis. You can see all these pictures of chronic plaque psoriasis. You can see all the pictures here. Now, gutted psoriasis is numerous and small lesions, less than 1 centimeter in diameter, pink with less scale than plaque psoriasis. The main differentiate between plaque and that is plaque psoriasis having a maximum scaling, and plaque is bigger in size, commonly found on trunk and proximal limbs, typically seen in individuals less than 30 years. This is gutted psoriasis. This is flexural psoriasis, lesions in skin folds, particularly groin, gluteal cleft, axilla, and submammary regions. So this is a flexural psoriasis. This is erythrodermic psoriasis. Generalized erythema covering entire skin surface may evolve slowly from chronic plaque psoriasis or appear as eruptive phenomenon. So this is a very picture of erythrodermic psoriasis. This is pustular psoriasis. This is two types, localized and generalized. More common is localized and uncommon is generalized. So this is pustular psoriasis. This is palmoplantar psoriasis, can be hyperkeratotic or pustular, may mimic dermatitis. Look for psoriatic manifestations elsewhere to aid the diagnosis, possibly aggravated by the trauma. So this is a picture of palmoplantar psoriasis. This is scalp psoriasis, varies from minor scaling with erythema to thick hyperkeratotic plaques, may extend beyond hairline. It's very typical. This is snail psoriasis, may be present in patient with any type of psoriasis. It can take several forms. So I will show you different types of nail psoriasis. This is also a type of nail psoriasis. This is also, you can see in the picture, nails. This is also nail psoriasis. liver psoriasis. Now, the most common complication of the psoriasis, that is psoriatic arthritis. Approximately 5 to 20% have associated arthritis. Five major patterns of psoriatic arthritis be like distal interphalangeal involvement, symmetrical polyarthritis, psoriatic spondyla, arthropathic arthritis multial. So it is almost similar to rheumatism. You can see it manifests clearly indicating similar to rheumatoid arthritis. So this is a very common complication. After it becomes chronic, most of the patient, almost 5 to 20%, they are getting with the psoriatic arthritis. So in addition to inflamed scaly skin, psoriatic arthritis caused pitted, discolored nails and the swollen, painful joints that are typical of arthritis. It can also lead to the inflammatory eye conditions such as conjunctivitis. Symptoms range from mild to severe, and psoriatic arthritis can affect any joint. Although the disease usually isn't as crippling as other forms of arthritis, but it can cause stiffness and progressive joint damage that in the most serious causes may lead to permanent deformity just like rheumatism. So now we need to also differentiate all these skin disorders with each other. So I will show you in the pictures, like seborrheic dermatitis, lichen planus, ringworm of the body, tinea corporis, pityriasis rosea. These are the similar condition can look like a psoriasis. So we need to know, we need to identify which skin disorder is this. So that's why I will show you in the picture. See, this is a very common, tinea corporis and psoriasis. In the picture, we will find definitely the difference between tinea corporis and psoriasis. Here also, discoid eczema and psoriasis. This is a differential diagnosis. We must know about the differential diagnosis. This is Bowen's disease and psoriasis, which is dermatitis and psoriasis, almost similar. We need to identify this is seborrheic dermatitis, first is, and second is psoriasis. See, mycosis fungoides and psoriasis. Pityriasis rosea and psoriasis. Secondary syphilis and psoriasis. See, gutted psoriasis, almost there are similarity between gutted psoriasis and secondary syphilis. Tinea cuneis and psoriasis. Atopic eczema and psoriasis. So we need to identify exactly. Tinea corporis and psoriasis. This is eczema and psoriasis, almost similar. You just find, we need to find out the scaling is there or not. Sometimes we need to go for biopsy to confirm the diagnosis. If we don't have any perfect diagnosis, then we need to go for biopsy to confirm the diagnosis. Eczema and psoriasis. So, now the treatment protocol. Very, we need to know the treatment of psoriasis according to the modern science. Some topical, like keep the skin moisturized, cream, ointments, lotions, shampoos, oils, corticosteroids, calcipotriol, vitamin D3 analogs, atenol, tazarotene, coltar, and enthraline. These are the topical ointments or lotion they are giving. Methotrexate for oral medicine, 6-thiazide, cyclosporine, acetirizine. Lots of oral medicine they are giving. Why we need to know about this medicine? Because most of the time, these patients, they are coming after consulting and taking medicines
from the Western dermatologist. Most of the time they are giving immunosuppressant medicine, some steroids, some methotrexate, some cyclosporin, right? So there are lots of side effects, particularly when they are switching over to such kind of medicine, they are taking, they are going for the liver profile, they are all the time going for the renal profile. So when the patient is coming to us, because these all the treatments have plenty of side effects. So before knowing the side effects of this treatment, if we start, and if anything happened to the patient, they will claim that it is due to the ayurvedic treatment. So we need to identify the side effects of the, these things. Before starting the treatment, we need to go for the renal profile, we need to go for the liver profile, and if there is any abnormalities we will found, then we need to explain the patient, because of you have consumed this allopathic treatment for the long time, we see the side effects. So if you start this, our treatment, it is not due to our treatment. So for the professional safety point of view, we need to identify, we need to explain the patient, we need to know the side effects of the Western medicine, and then we can start our treatment. So this is very important, friends. Some phototherapy treatment with ultraviolet, they are also like this, lifestyle modification and dietary changes. Moisturizer, they are offering some synthetic moisturizing, moisturizer cream or lotion they are offering. They also advise the patient to cover the affected areas overnight and wash it properly. Treatment of psoriasis, trigger if they are consuming alcohol, sun exposure, smoking and stress. So now they also advocating what Ayurveda is doing. Avoid drinking alcohol, now they also started to advise the patient to avoid alcohol consumption. They are also advocating healthy diet according to Ayurveda, because most of lots of dermatologists, they know now because they are having the limitations. So without maintaining diet and lifestyle, they also don't get the result. So now the side effects of all this thing, like modern treatment, oral side effects including liver damage, kidney problem, hypertension, increase the risk of infection, hair loss. Light therapy could lead to nausea, headache, or sometimes increase the risk of skin cancer. So we need to know all the side effects of this modern treatment, like methotrexate. You can see lots of side effects of methotrexate. Anemia, headache, mild and slow, hair loss, mouth sores, rash, vomiting, kidney damage, see the side effects of methotrexate. And most of the time patients are coming to us, they most of the time switching over to methotrexate. So now when they come to us, we need to gradually taper the methotrexate also. And we have done it successfully. See the side effects of this methotrexate. Side effects of oral retinoids, you can see. Bone and joint pain, bruising, depression, possibly suicide risk, eye problems, including blurred vision, cataracts, conjunctivitis, right? So these are the side effects of oral retinoids. Liver damage, nail problems, skin and mucous membrane problems, including dry nose. So these are the side effects of oral retinoids. Cyclosporin, lots of side effects, fatigue, gingivitis, gout, hair growth, headaches, joint pains, tremor. So these are the side effects of cyclosporin. Lots of side effects, liver problems, increase the risk of infection, lower down your immunity, right? Kidney damage. So we need to know which treatment patient has taken, and accordingly we need to explain the fact file of the side effects of the particular treatment. And after explaining all these pros and cons, then we can start our treatment. Now side effects of coltar, they are advising for the local application, stains on clothing, skin irritation, sun sensitivity. So these are the side effects of coltar. The same side effects of enthralin is also for the local application. Side effects of UV light, the long-term use of UV light may be associated with increased incidence of non-melanoma or melanoma of skin cancer. UV light therapy is contraindicated in the patient receiving cyclosporin and should be used with great care in all immunocompromised patients due to this increased risk of developing skin cancer. So these are the side effects of UV light. Now we are pitching over some success story. see this patient of psoriasis, you can see, and this is before treatment picture, this is during treatment picture, and this is after treatment picture. This was a Britisher who came to us in 2014, and he was having his psoriasis since 35 years. And he tried everything, but never tried for Ayurveda. Then he came to Atharva Ayurveda for the treatment. And we started the treatment with Ayurveda Panchakarma protocol. He stayed with us for 3 weeks. And then you see this before treatment picture. See, he never got any benefit with any treatment. But on the 10th day of the treatment, you just find the result. Then he continued the treatment for long term. When I met him twice when I visited London, he is still taking our oral medicine and taking care of Kai. Even he was on the HSBC bank, and that was a very stressful job. So I advise him if he can manage to go for another job. So he immediately left the job, and now he is managing the stress. This is also a picture of this one more psoriasis patient. See before after treatment photographs. This is also you can see before after treatment photograph of the psoriasis patient. See, this is a video actually. I think it's one on the spine for you.
We can't hear the video, sir.
Is not listen the video? This patient was having psoriasis and he was suffering since last 5 years, and he was being at Atharva for the treatment. He was going to Panchakarma twice. Since last 3 years, he's totally psoriasis free. He's living in the Vakaner near to Rajkot, and he got married and he's enjoying, and still he's in my touch. So the thing is that because all the skin disorders, psoriasis particularly, always stands for recurrence. So we need to explain the all these pros and cons. Whatever the diet and lifestyle we advise, we should need to follow strictly throughout the life. And that is the skill we need to develop. And once they will come in touch with us, we have that communication skill. We need to develop that convincing power. The patient needs to follow thoroughly for throughout the life. And then I have number of patients, they are since last 5, 6, 10 years, they are living psoriasis free. Because this is the disease, always even little bit of causative factor is there, it will reoccur. So these are the encouraging results what we are getting. So this is the picture of his before after treatment. Now this is very interesting video.
We can't listen.
You can't listen. I will hear you. Don't worry. Now it is there. Now are you listening?
No, sir.
Okay.
Don't worry.
I will tell you. He is Antonio. He is from Spain. He was also having psoriasis since last 18 years when he came to us before 5 years. And he was also almost full body psoriasis, and he tried all the conventional treatment. And he never got any result. He was here for 4 times for the treatment protocol, Panchakarma. At least our treatment protocol, we have given the name of this particular treatment protocol is complete skin detoxification treatment. That is the name we have given to the treatment protocol. So he was here for 4 times, and since last 3 years he is not coming, but he is continuously with our diet, lifestyle and medicine. I was there in the October at Spain, Madrid. I spent 2 days with him. Even particularly in this COVID condition, he's in touch with me. He and his family entirely safe with our Ayurvedic treatment protocol. I have mentioned him to stay safe during this COVID condition. So the patient who was having 18 years old psoriasis and he was tired with all this conventional treatment, switching over to Ayurveda treatment protocol, switching over to diet, lifestyle and stress management, since last 4 years, he is asymptomatic, there is no recurrence of psoriasis. So this is, I would like to say, why I am sharing this, because I would like to encourage everybody, we need to generate the data. We need to provide the evidence. So this is a clear-cut evidence to the Western dermatologists, or those who are asking or seeking evidence-based Ayurveda. So this is the thing what I would like to tell everybody. So this is before treatment picture, after treatment picture. You can see, this is one more patient, this is also a video. He was suffering from psoriasis since last more than 5 years. And he was in Ahmedabad, he is still in Ahmedabad, and he is asymptomatic since last 3 years. So this is the strength of Ayurveda. See the before after treatment picture, you can see. So the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. So now I have one more video of the doctor. She is MBBS, she was in final MBBS when she started our treatment. She was having gutted psoriasis and she was in final MBBS. And she started our treatment, she also went through considerable treatment. She knows the limitations of Western medicine, so she immediately followed our other treatment. And she is now completely asymptomatic and she passed the final MBBS also. I have the video, if it is possible, I will show you the video of that particular MBBS doctor. So Western doctors are also taking our treatment. So now the management of psoriasis, that is very important. So psoriasis is a deep rooted in Sapta Dhatu. So internal cleansing of body is the first step. So Panchakarma has the vital role in the management of psoriasis. Balancing dosha and tissue nourishment, that is also a line of treatment. Enhancing the immune system to fight the disease and some external activation. So this is the basic line of treatment. And the treatment protocol we have established at Atharva Ayurveda, that is our standard operating procedure, SOP, called Sampurna Tvacha Shuddhikaran Chikitsa, means complete skin detoxification treatment. Hello. Established wonderful result in skin diseases, especially psoriasis, eczema. Kindly mute your microphone. Hello. Hello, can you use your microphone? So our complete skin treatment is too effective. Kindly mute your microphone, please. Rapidly increases skin disease and protoglobin, which Western medication has no role. So this is... Hello, please mute your microphone. So this is complete skin detoxification treatment, the protocol we have developed. And it's very useful in psoriasis, eczema, dry skin, or all chronic skin disease condition. And what we are doing, that the treatment of psoriasis based on internal detoxification through Ayurvedic Panchakarma treatment, including external detoxification, stress management, internal detoxification, diet management, lifestyle management. We are doing Rakta Moksha also. Treatment, main we are focusing on the counseling to the patients, lifestyle, diet management and stress management. Counseling is very important because the patient is coming with very less hope because they tried everything and without any result. Some oral allergic medicines, some immunomodulators for immunity, some external applications, regular follow-up, yoga and meditation to relieve the mental stress. So this is our treatment protocol for the particularly psoriasis and all skin disorders. Stress management is very important and maintain a healthy lifestyle in order to adapt to this condition. Regular exercise. Regular exercise, stress management are also very important. Yogic asanas, pranayam can help you keep your mind and body fit and healthy. Shirodhara treatment. And main, we are focusing on the diet. So diet and lifestyle management is the main key. Hello. So diet is very important. We all the time asking or seeking the patient to go for vegetarian diet. That is very sattvic diet. That is very important. So this is our formulation, herbs what we are using for the psoriasis patient. We have our Sortal herbal tea and it contains Manjishta, Anantmul, Haridrakhan, Swaramukhi. The main line of treatment, the main Chikisa Sutra for skin disorder is Puna Puna Shodhan. Again and again, detoxification or purification treatment. So that's why we have added Swaramukhi and Harde in our combination of Sortal herbal tea, herbal powder. This is our Sortal powder and Soro cream. All this, we went through a clinical trial. We have a research on that and that we have introduced, we have registered this product. We have our a small pharmacy named Green Tree Botanicals. This is our A-Soro capsule. We are maintaining all these international standards protocol for the preparation of all these herbs. And we have conducted this research clinical trial for this particular protocol. So it's a big, so I'm just switching over. So this is Ashwagandha, Shatavari, Guruchi, Manjishta, Anandpul, Chopchini, Haridrakhan, Neem, Harde, Sonamukhi, Brahmi. This is our formulation. We are that including Ashwagandha for the immunity patient. Guruchi is also very good in immunomodulator, Haridrakhan, you know, Neem, Sonamukhi. So Puna Puna Shodhan, that's why we included some laxatives in our formulation. So patient get good result. External treatment is very important. What we are using for the psoriasis characterized by inflammation. So the anti-inflammatory properties, here what we are using, that is coconut, virgin coconut oil, make this a perfect treatment option. Even in the, when they are coming for the Abhyanga in our for the culture, when they are coming for the BHA treatment or this thing, we are using the base of coconut oil. The fact that the coconut oil result in absolutely no side effects make this an even more attractive option. Unprocessed virgin coconut oil is the most effective and can be applied directly to the affected areas of the skin. Coconut oil can be used as a topical ointment and is a safe and effective treatment for psoriasis. It has been used to moisturize the skin for centuries. However, the true benefit of coconut oil comes from its antiseptic and anti-inflammatory property. The active ingredients in coconut oil are the medium chain fatty acid, that is called MCFA. This medium chain fatty acids penetrate the skin to the connective tissues where they reduce the cellular inflammation. And the MCFAs found in coconut oil also increase the blood flow to the skin by improving blood vessel function. Finally, this MCFA destroys the free radicals, that is, which are the compounds that encourage the skin inflammation. So, the coconut oil does not exert its effect immediately. When applied to the skin, the bacteria on the skin react with MCFA and turn them into the free fatty acids. it is these three fatty acids that ultimately reduce the chronic inflammation, and which is the hallmark of both eczema and psoriasis. So generally, it takes several days before the anti-inflammatory effect of coconut oil on psoriasis are evident. So this is a very, you know, good, very natural moisturizer of the skin. Now the treatment protocol of the psoriasis in Ophthalmobot we have settled. We are giving a 2 or 3 weeks treatment protocol, particularly for the patient, those who are coming from the overseas. And for the Abhyanga and Svedana, we are using the base of coconut oil. We can add something like, sometimes we are using taranj or sometimes neem oil. But most of the time, we are just giving the massage or Abhyanga with the coconut oil. For the Snehana, we are using Panchatikta Dhruta. It's very good for all skin disorder, skin condition. So Panchatikta Grit is the Snehan. We have a specific treatment protocol. I am using the nano concept for the treatment because patients are coming sometimes only for 2 weeks. So we need to perform the treatment within the limited frame. So we are giving only 50 grams of Panchatikta Grit for 5 days with Abhyanga and Svedana for 7 days. And on 8 days, we are giving them a virechan treatment most of the time with Abhayadi Moda. And we are following all the Sausajan Kram, and also if time permits, if the patient is coming from the overseas, we are going for the bloodletting. During their stay at Atharva, we are giving the stress management treatment protocol with meditation. We are giving some Sirodhara treatment. We are providing the sattvic diet to the patient. And then we advise them to continue the oral herbal treatment, at least for the long term, and the diet and lifestyle management throughout the life. And that is the key of our success for the all the skin disorders, particularly at Atharva Ayurveda. So quality of life issues, art of medicine is to bring comfort, and it is an art of loving and kindness. This is the one book I have written that is available on the Amazon.com, Ayurveda, the Science of Life. This is our social media and our websites and availability on online. So we help you to live a healthy life. Thank you for this very important session on psoriasis. If you have any question, you can feel free to ask us. And it will be my pleasure to solve all your queries. I hope everybody enjoyed.
Hello.
Yes.
Yes, sir. There is a chat box at the right side of your screen. A thinking doctor would type the questions in that chat box. So you can
Yes. Please share the proper protocol for kids skin disease. Yes. So I already share my treatment protocol that it's a combination of treatment protocol, not only that by giving medicine, but we are following complete Panchakarma treatment protocol. We are giving them Snehan, Svedan, Abhyanga in proper manner. And we are providing the stress management protocol. We are providing them diet and lifestyle modifications. Particularly, all these skin disorders, they are psychosomatic in the nature. So we are focusing maximum on Chikisa Sutra of psoriasis, that is Puna Puna Shodhan. That is the main Chikisa Sutra, and that is common for maximum all skin disorders. So our treatment protocol derives from Shodhan, then Saman Chikisa, diet, lifestyle modifications, counseling to the patient is very important. So we are providing psychological counseling to the patient, stress management, and round the clock help. We are providing all the time to the patient, those who are not in the Rajkot, but they are staying away or they are settling in other countries. Then we are all the time chatting, we are giving them the WhatsApp number. If they have any question, they can ask anytime. Which coconut oil should be used, regular cold compress? It's very regular, very natural, very virgin, unprocessed coconut oil is good. There is, you can go for the Khadi Gramodyog Bhandar, or you can go to the Ghani where they are preparing, they are making this fresh virgin coconut oil. So we need to have this fresh virgin unprocessed virgin coconut oil. Greek, I already told you about that Panchatikta Greek is very ideal. Sometimes we can use Kripala Krut for the vinegar, but most of the time we are using this particularly. Tomato is not good, but lemon to rehydrate the skin because swelling is there. So we need to rehydrate the skin. So we can offer lemonade or lemon drink. Okay, how to deal with pustular psoriasis, sir? So again and again, we are focusing not only for the external application, we need to cleanse internally. That is the main line of treatment. So we need to focus on the Shodhan Chikitsa. How can we manage the recurrent psoriasis? Very, very good question. Recurrence of psoriasis depend upon the patient's mental status and patient's diet and lifestyle. So we need to explain them. Particularly, psoriasis reoccur in the season of winter. So all the time when they are on the treatment protocol, we are explaining them that from November to February, if you found that if you are having this problem, just come to us, start the oral and external treatment protocol, and guided, we are advising them to go for the Virechan or Shuddhikaran Chikitsa during this 4 months of period. And at least once in year, particularly from November to February, we are advising all the patients to take care of the skin, the diet, the lifestyle, and the stress management, because in the winter there is a lots of possibility of recurrence. And particularly we are focusing, we are advising, explaining the patient to avoid uneven lifestyle. We are advising to have a scheduled, very disciplined lifestyle. They need to particularly have a scheduled lunch few a time, scheduled dinner time, breakfast time, and sleep. We are advising them to take proper sleep. That is very important because these all are psychosomatic disorders. How to deal with the psoriatic arthritis? Again, the causative factor is psoriasis. So first we need to clear the psoriasis, and that definitely helps them to control the psoriatic arthritis, because it's a psoriatic complication. We need to first clear the psoriasis, and it's psoriatic arthritis is there. So we just help them to minimize the pain, because it's a permanent problem. So we just help them to minimize the pain. It is not completely curable. Psoriatic arthritis is not completely curable. Second thing I would like to tell you, never claim for any disorders, psoriasis to arthritis, never claim. We are just providing them and help them to manage the disorders. After managing the problem, we need to explain them, your skin is now normal. Now it is in your hand. That you need to follow that lifestyle and diet style throughout the life. You need to manage the stress management throughout the life. Then your skin will remain normal. Yes, you can go for Arogyavardhini, Gandhak Rasayan, Rasayan Chikitsa, Ashwagandha, Guruchi, Shatavari, or normal Rasayan Chuna we can use for the immunomodulation. Which liver drugs used? We can use Liv52DS, it's very good. Herbs I'm using, and for the sometimes we are using Immusante for the immunomodulation, that is a product from Himalaya, for the stress management, for the immunomodulation. This treatment should be continued lifetime? Most probably no. At least I have observed patient, we are advising at least for 3 to 4 years, then gradually we are tapering the treatment. We just advise them to keep lifestyle and diet in very disciplined manner, and we are observing. Particularly, we ask the patient to continue during the winter season, continue the treatment during the winter season after tapering the treatment. So this is our this treatment. Why does your combination doesn't have rasa ausadhi? See, it depends upon your style of practicing, and we are getting the result with only plant-based medicine. That's why we are not focusing on this particular this rasa ausadhi. But you may use Arogyavardhini, Gandhak Rasayan, or Rasa Manikya. I am not a rasa vaidya. I'm not the expert of rasa chikitsa, but we are getting the good result with only Shodhan Chikitsa and plant-based medicine. So that's why we are using this protocol. We suggest some medications easily available to every. There are lots of herbs, QT Swara for Vasu. Then Dectimo PF, that is a formulation from Vital Care, that is a Gujarat based company. Dectimo oil, QT Swara oil, and then there is one company from South, that is 777 oil, you can use. Then they are having lots of product for psoriasis that they are also having. We can taper, Dr. Jayasri, we can taper gradually all the allopathy medicine. Not that the patient is taking this medicine since along. Gradually we can go for the taper of this allopathy medicine. And definitely after tapering the medicine, if we go in the right direction, then people can directly switch over to the Ayurveda. There is no need of any Western medicine. I have lots of patients, they are taking this Ayurvedic medicine very successfully without any recurrence, but it requires your confidence that you will be able to communicate this thing properly with the patient, and you need to convince the patient. Your convincing power is very important. Yes. Kids also, for the kids, very interesting question, Sonal Sharma. For the kids, we are counseling to the parents of the patient, because it's very difficult to maintain the diet and lifestyle of the kid. But we are explaining the patient parents that if you will follow a diet and lifestyle, because something that is not good for the psoriasis patient, so if they will avoid that diet and lifestyle, then kid will never demand, and very less amount of the medicine. Some diet and lifestyle protocol, we are also taking the kids. There is no problem. Why VHN and not woman? We are doing woman, but very less patient requires the woman. If we can manage with Puna Shodhan, mild to moderate VHN, then why we need to take risk? Because of professional's safety point of view, we are not often go for the woman chikitsa. If we are taking the result with the VHN, then it's better, it's risk-free, and it's very easy, very convenient for the patient also. Sometimes patient don't want to go for woman. Maximum time patient also don't want to go for the woman. So for the particularly this treatment, VHN treatment is ideally we are adopting. What is things about this atopic dermatitis in treatment? Here all we can also need to apply the same treatment protocol with the dosage management. Atopic dermatitis is also a contagious disorder, also having the tendency of recurrence. So we need to take care. We can use some other products like QT's capsule or QT's tablet and QT's oil for the application of Vasu Pharma, Dectimo oil, Dectimo cream we are using for the atopic dermatitis. Diet and lifestyle are the same. We need to focus maximum on diet and lifestyle. What area of apathy triggering factors that should be avoided? That already I mentioned, Dr. Sujata, in my slides. If patient AC inhibitors, should we stop it? No. We can't stop it AC inhibitors because they are taking antihypertensive. But we need to explain them that if they follow other diet and lifestyle, definitely with that medicine we can plan this treatment, because we cannot stop antihypertensive. If it is possible, if the cardiologist of the patient can switch over to other types of antihypertensive medicine, there is no problem. But being an Ayurvedic physician, we cannot advise them to stop the AC inhibitors. Chakradhara, yes, very useful, yes, very good. We are doing the Takradhara, yes, it is also very good and it has a very good result. So you can go for Takradhara also, not an issue. Any question? Yes, there are lots of kids are also having psoriasis and some oral treatments. Or in the form of herbal tea, we are giving them the treatment. We are advising the parents to take care of the diet and everything. and by that way we are managing also these things. Any question? Hello.
Hello.
Yes, you can use Rasa Upsuti Novat and issue. As I told you, Arogya Vardhini is good, Rasmanike is good, but we are getting result with only this plant based medicine and Suna Apuna Apuna Sodhan Chikisa. That's why at least as of now we never go for this types of any Rasa Upsuti. But you can go for Rasa Upsuti, not an issue. This treatment should be continued lifetime. Most of the treatment plan are for 3 to 4 years. Then gradually we are advising patient to taper the treatment, but they need to continue the diet and lifestyle medications what we are advising. Our combination doesn't have any resources. Qtisora, I tell you, 777 oil is very good, available in the market. Some good herbs from Charak Pharma is also good there. Bactimo MF or Bactimo P, that is a capsule available from Vital Care Pharma from Gujarat. So this is also having a good result. Right. Diabetic with psoriasis, what we can do? Yes, we need to manage both, we need to continue. We cannot go for the Tivra Virajan or Tivra Shodhan Chikisa. We can go for Gudu Chikisa, Gudu Shodhan with the balance of diabetes. And Madhumeh is can be a triggering factor for the psoriasis patient. So first we need to control diabetes, then we can plan our treatment. Genetically transferred chances from parents to kids, 70-30% ratio. 30% chances are there to transmit or to transfer the chances from parents to kids. Can we use coconut oil for Abhyantar Snayan? Yes, you can go for Abhyantar Snayan also. Sir, we can use something more about dandruff and scalp psoriasis. Yes, there is a hair zone spray from Himalaya that is very good for dandruff. One more oil, I just forget the name, from Charak Pharma. And that is also very good for the dandruff. We need to clear the dandruff, particularly if the patient is having a dandruff, then there is always the chance of developing psoriasis. Interval between two shodhana, at least I'm giving at, by every 3 months I'm going for mrudu virechan. Pediatric dose of no, we are not giving any virechan to the pediatric patient, but by giving our this Sorotel herbal tea with minimum dose, it definitely, because it contains some laxatives in that, like what I can say, sonamukhi and herde, so it will give indirect virechan to the patient, so it will cleanse. So our motto is to give puna puna shodhan. It will be maintained through our herbal tea, so that is enough for the psoriatic patient, for the kid. So thank you all. I think the questions are over. Still, if you have any question, feel free to ask me, and it will be my pleasure to solve your queries. My cell number is 9825163953. That is also my WhatsApp number. So you can ask me if you have any problem or any queries. It will be a pleasure for me to share all my knowledge with you. So thank you, Dr. Garje and team of MAST, for this very interesting session, and hope you all enjoyed this talk. And that's it from my side.
Thank
Hello.
You, sir.
Yes.
Thank you, sir, for wonderful, knowledgeable session. Now we'd like to proceed further for out of time session. Request Seema Garje ma'am, who is the organizer of MAST, please start out of time session. Dr. Seema ma'am.
Hello.
Thank you, sir. Myself, Dr. Seema Garje. Thank you being a part of such a knowledgeable.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello. First of all, I'm very thankful to our honorable guest, Dr. Gaurav Joshi sir, for giving us a very knowledge about the psoriasis. Also, I'm thankful to our organization council, Dr. Abhijit Hodkar, Dr. Hello?
Yeah, go ahead.
Didat Bhopi sir, Vaidya Nitin Pati, Vaidya Anita Phattare, Vaidya Ganesh Pajai, Vaidya Kushal Kaishika sir, Vaidya Durga Dattavyas, Vaidya Sheetal Trivedi ma'am, Vaidya Sonali Kautikar ma'am, Vaidya Tejas Pati, and I'm also thankful to our registration heads, Vaidya Sujit Dundre sir, Vaidya Hitendra Badale sir, Vaidya Janvi Dadane ma'am, and I'm thankful to our Majdi President, Dr. Ramdas sir. Because of him, we are arranging such a kind of knowledgeable CMEs in this crucial time period. And last but not least, I'm also thankful to all audience doctors for listening very peacefully and giving much coordination. Thank you. Thank you all. Be with us for next CME on tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you all. Thank you. Namaskar. See you all again.
Namaskar, sir.
Thank you. Okay, bye.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Okay, bye.